I'd like to take a bit of your time and discuss video game journalists and video game journalism. In response to one of Giant Bomb's so-called games journalists, Abby. I was unable to find her last name, and it's not really important. I'm not trying to disparage this person specifically. I'm mainly trying to use her as yet another example of people who don't belong in the business of video game journalism. Just being bad at playing games itself isn't enough to make me dislike these kinds of games journalists, but it definitely is a major factor. Most of my problem with these so-called games journalists is that they mistake their lack of skill at gaming for an error on the game's part. Add to that the fact that many of them don't even like games or play them regularly, and it doesn't make sense to me that these people would seek a job like that, and it makes even less sense that someone would hire a person who doesn't like, care about, or even really play games to write articles and reviews about games. To help put it in perspective, consider sports journalists or commentators. Would it make sense to hire someone like me who doesn't play sports, doesn't know all the rules for the different sports, and could care less about sports to be a sports journalist or commentator? No, because not only am I unqualified to do that, I don't have any interest in the subject matter. It's the same for video game journalists. People who aren't qualified to write about and review games shouldn't be being hired to do so. People who prove that they're not qualified to write about games and prove that they don't really care about games shouldn't be allowed to continue being games journalists. They're a detriment to the industry as a whole and make actual games journalists less likely to be listened to. There's also the fact that several of these journalists just want to write for mainstream media networks and are only writing about games as a means to an end. They see it as beneath them to have to write about video games, and that shows in the way some of these people write about video games. I don't think Abby was doing anything like that in her video, so I don't want anyone to think I'm talking about her here. I don't think she should be a games journalist solely because she shows she has no talent for games and such little respect for them that she's not even willing to do a quick Google search to find out how to change the settings in a remastered game. It'd be one thing if it was a new game that there was no information online for, but this game was already out for a while. Not to mention the fact that anyone who plays video games knows that games have option menus where you can change the settings. To not look for one and to not bother doing a quick Google search for 5 hours while playing a game shows how little she actually cares about games. Someone who cared about doing a good job reviewing that game would have taken the time at the start of finding the controls to be inverted, to go and find out how to change that to their liking. She couldn't be bothered with that and also couldn't be bothered to try different buttons on a controller to see if what she was looking for would pop up. It's lazy and something a bad games journalist would do. But that's not what I'm trying to focus on here. In fact, I'm mostly talking about the person who feigned outrage, or worse, were actually outraged, over The Last of Us 2's trailer. As well as the other people like that who are either truly upset by various concepts being introduced into video games or are just faking it because they think it will get noticed more if they try to ride the wave of fake outrage our society seems to be struggling with at the moment. I understand that we're dealing the tail end of the natural result of generations of people resisting change and becoming upset by difficult topics being introduced into new forms of media. For example, the outrage people had when TV tried to bring up sex is similar to the outrage people have now when video games try to do it. It's the same with violence, rape, profanity, etc. All the things that people have been able to discuss in books for centuries is suddenly outrageous when introduced into other forms of media for some reason. It doesn't make sense and seems to be counterproductive to the progression of society. It's the kind of thing angry old people have been known for generations. It also comes off as something a scared person would do. Remember when old people were terrified of jazz music and then rock and roll and then rap music? They're the same kinds of people who get upset about profanity in movies, video games, or TV. It also contributes to future generations being infected with those kinds of beliefs as well. As those people grow up being conditioned to be outraged over these things, they pass that on to their kids who take that outrage and add their own and pass both on to their kids as well, and it just builds and builds over the generations. It's why we went from relatively uncensored TV to the overly censored and almost unbearably fake TV shows we have now in America. Sure, we've made a bit of progress in terms of what profanity we're allowed to use on TV, but most of it's still censored, sexual content is still censored, and depending on the network, violence is heavily censored as well. Hell, Comedy Central fully cuts out the audio of any profanity in the movies they show on their channel. Not to mention the growing list of politically incorrect words that they'll censor. I don't know if anyone else remembers that they used to say the word midget and now that just gets cut out. I get that it's politically incorrect now, but to bleep it on TV as though it's just as bad as saying fuck is just ridiculous. Especially considering it's a step backwards. Detroit Become Human is another example of video games getting negative press from so-called games journalists just trying to push more fake outrage into the world. The people who try to get other people outraged by things like this are the ones that are the problem for society. They're the ones damaging society, and if it weren't for people like them doing what they do, we wouldn't be here now. It's people pushing the narrative that violence or sexual content in video games or TV are detrimental to society that are actually the detriment to society. Trying to get people outraged over something that bothers you as though it's a bad thing for everyone and not just a problem on your end is how we got in this mess. People who pretend that we have to censor these things in TV or video games to, quote, protect the children are really just hiding the fact that it bothers them personally. They can't articulate well enough why those things bother them, so they just pretend those things are bad for everyone. These things aren't the problem, the fact that these people get outraged by these things is the problem. Is anyone seriously going to say that we have to stop kids from learning profanity? Yes, people do think that, but no one will ever tell you why. Not in a way that makes sense, anyway. What's their response when you mention the fact that children are going to learn those words and use them by the time they're adults? What's the point of stopping kids from using those words since it's going to be perfectly fine once they grow up to use them? What's the point of stopping people from using them around children? It doesn't make any sense, and it's the same with violence and sexual content in video games. Why do they have to stop people from broaching these subjects in video games? Why is it okay for books to bring up the topic of domestic violence, but it's outrageous for a video game to do it? Why is it okay for a book to talk about prostitution or sexual content, but it's outrageous for video games to do the same? Why is it okay for a book to be incredibly violent, but video games have to walk a fine line or risk outraging people? The answer is obvious: because of people like these so-called games journalists. People like them spend their time trying to get people outraged over various things and then use that outrage to justify their argument that those things were outrageous in the first place. It's kind of like when you antagonize someone and try to get a reaction out of them and then pretend like you did nothing wrong and acting shocked when that person gets pissed at you and retaliates. It's a self-sufficient cycle of outrage feeding outrage to justify its own outrage. People like that should stay out of gaming journalism. They obviously want to write about something else besides video games, and reviews or showcases of games isn't the place to pushing a political or societal agenda. These games journalists should be focusing on the aspects of the games that matter, like whether the game functions, whether it's fun to play, is the story interesting, things like that. It's not the place to try and create outrage over the natural progression of society. As technology and society itself evolves, more mediums to tell stories become available. If it weren't for fake outrage games journalists have been creating since the beginning of the video game industry, these so-called outrageous topics would have become mainstream ages ago and would be considered commonplace now. Similar to how books and movies are now largely able to bring up whatever subject they want, video games will be able to do the same thing one day. It's incredibly disappointing that we have to fight fake games journalists and the fake outrage they try to spread in the world before we can get there. Anyway, with that, I'm going to end this video. I feel like I'm talking in circles at this point, and I feel like if I haven't gotten my point across by now, I'm just not able to articulate it properly myself. I'd like to know what all of you think about this. Do you think journalists creating the outrage are themselves the reason there's so much outrage over what video games are trying to do? Do you agree with the outrage? If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. And stay safe till next time. Error. Error. Error.